Shares in Alecto Minerals are soaring after the company revealed a positive feasibility study on its Matala Gold project in Zambia and a financing agreement to build and develop the site. We have Chief Executive Mark Jones on the line. Hello, Mark.
Hi, Charlotte. How are you?
I'm very well. Thank you very much. And you must be very well, too, because the news comes only 5 months after you bought the mine. You must be very pleased.
Yes, I must admit, we always knew that we had to hit the ground running, and I think we've proven that that's exactly what we've achieved.
So tell us a bit more about the highlights of this feasibility study.
Yes, I think it's worth for your listeners to just recap and say that when we acquired the project, it already had a mining license and an environmental permit and an existing feasibility study done by Coffee Mining in Perth, but at a higher gold price. And it was important for us to find a way of making a project in the current environment. And we did that, and we talked about, last time we spoke, we talked about the fact that we had completed a scoping study. And we did that by moving the initial focus from Dunrobin, which is one of the two historic mines, to Matala. So once we had acquired the project, we started working with PenMin, which we announced in December, and they put together a feasibility study, and we're able to fast-track that because a huge amount of the work had been completed, obviously, in the original bankable feasibility study put down by Coffee. So we've now been able to complete that process. It's a fairly small project, but small is good. It means it's low risk, which means we can have greater confidence we can achieve it. It's 400,000 tons per annum, but it's good grades at just over 2.7 grams a ton. And wonderfully, it's the oxide and transitional materials, which means that from a processing point of view, it's a very simple gravity and a CIL plant. So again, what we're trying to do here is move forward rapidly, quickly, and at as low a risk as possible. So we have an estimated capital cost for the plant coming out of the study at a little under $14.5 million. And that provides us with very strong economics with an NPV of just under $29 million and an IRR of 52%, and that's an unleveraged IRR, so that's particularly strong. So very pleasing, but we needed that to make sure that we had an opportunity to bring finance on board.
Okay, so let's talk a bit more about the finance then, how you will finance the development of this project. You are talking to two Chinese companies. Can you tell us a bit more about how this could work?
Yeah, PenMin have been particularly good partners in this process. Not only were they able to fast-track the feasibility study, but they had relationships pre-existing with Chinese entities which had already partnered with them on other projects in Africa, private companies, but still operational entities. So it was a proven track, proven path, shall I say, for them. So in essence, what we did was we went to China in January with PenMin, and we spoke to a company called Xinhai, and Xinhai confirmed that in principle they were interested in getting involved with Zambia. The Chinese like Africa and they like gold. So when we sat down, we said to them, right, what would make a feasibility study bankable for you? They provided us exactly what they required, and that was why it was tailored to meet their needs. Hence, it was completed back in February with the numbers I mentioned earlier. So it wasn't difficult then to understand how quickly they'd come back and say they were comfortable with that and that they would be happy to provide the vendor finance that's critical for us to move the project forward.
Okay, so what's next then, Mark?
Well, the next step is that we've got to complete that financing. We're going through a detailed design phase as we speak. To make sure that we now have everything as de-risked as possible. We need to finalise the terms. It's a loan facility, but we're just working out how best to achieve that, creating as much value for our stakeholders as possible. And then once that's done, we need to sign up a mining contract. The good news there, of course, is that Our biggest shareholder is a contract mining company, so I think it'd be quite logical to think that that shouldn't be too challenging for us to gain that piece. And then we've got the biggest of the three legs of the financing in place. Then it's a matter of just coming up with the working capital. But considering we've gained so much without diluting at the project level, and we haven't had to worry about utilizing our future gold sales, there are opportunities for picking up working capital as we develop this path, which weren't open to us before. So obviously a lot more to do, but we've de-risked it significantly, and as a result, we're more bullish.
And Mark, I understand it's still very early days, but are you able to give us a bit more information about the timeline for all this?
Yeah, look, the problem with timelines, as we all know, is that if you achieve them, it's wonderful, you get a pat on the back. But if something unforeseen happens and you miss a timeline by a month or two, everyone starts to think that you're a bit of a muttonhead. But I think with confidence we can say that our target of commissioning a mine in the first half of next year is attainable. Okay, we've got a lot of work to be done, but as I said just now, it's hugely comforting to know that some of the bigger issues have already been put behind us. So yeah, I think with a big dollop of understanding that we don't control everything, our stakeholders should be looking forward to us commissioning in the first half of 2017.
Okay, Mark, thank you very much.
Pleasure.
Mark Jones, Chief Executive at Alecto Minerals.